The Kabaka of Buganda, Ronald Muwenda Mutebi II, has returned home after several months in Namibia where he had gone for medical care. The king was received at Entebbe International Airport VIP lounge by the Nabagereka cast, Livia Najinda, the Buganda Premier Charles Peter Mayiga, his eldest son, Prince Junju, daughter Victoria Nkizi, and Nalinya Agnes Nabaloga. The royal family has, however, asked the public to give the Kabaka privacy and accord him dignity. In a press statement, Junju said they thanked God for healing the Kabaka, which has enabled him to return to Buganda. However, he noted that the Kabaka is still in the hands of his doctors and he still needs treatment and rest until he fully recovers. Last week, Namibia said it had declined a visa extension to the king visiting for medical treatment after rumors spread that he had been abducted. The rumors sparked protests that, according to the Namibian government, put diplomatic staff abroad at risk. U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris wasted no time launching her 2024 presidential campaign, seeking the support of fellow Democrats with the backing of President Joe Biden after he pulled out of the race amid concerns about his age and health. In a statement, she praised President Joe Biden's patriotic decision not to seek re-election and vowed to win the Democratic nomination and defeat Donald Trump. She said, "With this selfless and patriotic act, President Biden is doing what he has done throughout his life of service, putting the American people and our country above everything else," she said in a statement. "I am honored to have the president's endorsement, and my intention is to earn and win this nomination. I'll do everything in my power to unite the Democratic Party and unite our nation to defeat Donald Trump."
To truly protect reproductive freedoms, we must restore the protections of Roe. Because you see, what the United States Supreme Court took, Congress can put back in place. May God bless you all, and may God bless the United States of America.
Her campaign officials and allies made hundreds of calls on behalf of Harris yesterday, urging delegates to the Democratic Party convention next month to join in nominating her for president in the November 5th election against Republican Donald Trump. Harris, a 59-year-old, would fashion an entirely new dynamic with Trump, 78, offering a vivid generational and cultural split screen. The United States has yet to elect a woman president in its 248-year history. In a bid to restore the environment, students of Kaperemoru Army Boarding School, through their Green Schools Environmental Club, are using plastic bottles to beautify their compound. Brianna Enang, the chairperson of the group, said they collect the bottles from surrounding villages and barracks every weekend.
We told them how the things are recycled and make Sweden, and can be used to make what? To make an educative stuff.
The students also started different projects under the Green Schools Initiative, including best farming practices, liquid soap making, among many others, to save the environment. Enang says under the farming project, they grow crops such as groundnuts, tomatoes, and they sell to the communities around the school. David Ochaka, the teacher in charge of the initiative, said they have so far planted over 100 trees since last year. The trees work as shade and provide fruits for the students.
It also helps us in case of herbal medicine. As you are seeing, we have the neem trees there, where we always go and pick the leaves, we cook, and help us in healing of some diseases like malaria.
The students are also trained in making and using environmentally friendly stoves.
The world concerning our environmental, then there's trouble with